There is lots of talking recently about Intel's possible degradation issues on its high-end 13th and 14th generation CPUs. I already did a video about that, but in this video we will have some real test data and my clear thoughts on this matter. Since I have a high-end solution, Powernetics version 2, that allows me to take precise CPU power measurements, I will put it to use. This is a system that I designed and developed along with Channel Well Technology, and if you want one, you can get it from wsn.gr. Here is a table showing all the power profiles that I will test in this video. Intel doesn't recommend the baseline power profile because it greatly affects the CPU's performance. It suggests implementing the highest power delivery profile compatible with each individual motherboard design. As you will see in my test results, the baseline profile does hurt performance. I used a strong cooling solution to check how high the Intel CPU can go if all limits are removed. The load application is the Prime 95 small FFTs, which applies a tremendous load to the processor. To test the CPU's performance under the different power profile settings, I use Cinebench R23. I have the Powernetics system to continually measure the CPU's power consumption, which is way more accurate and faster than using a software solution. Test results. There is no significant difference in power consumption between the insane and extreme power profiles. On the contrary, the difference between the former power profiles and the performance and baseline ones is vast. The power consumption between the performance and baseline profiles is only around 10 Watt. Contrary to the average power consumption readings, the peak readings have significant differences. As you can see, the i9-13900K peaks at 492 Watt in the insane profile, while in the extreme profile, its peak power consumption is close to 432 Watt. The CPU's peak power consumption is far from the corresponding applied BIOS settings, even at the more conservative performance and baseline power profiles. Imagine this processor paired with an NVIDIA RTX 4090 with a 600 Watt BIOS. Thankfully, all ATX version 3 and version 3.1 PSUs can handle up to 200% of the max power spikes. The average CPU temperature between the insane and extreme profiles is minimal. The differences between the performance and baseline profiles is also small, but the difference between the aforementioned profile pairs is vast. There are slight differences between the pairs or profiles, but the frequency difference is huge between these profile pairs, insane, extreme, and performance baseline. In Cinebench R23, the insane profile offers the highest performance, as expected, with a notable difference from the rest. The baseline profile heavily impacts the CPU's performance, while the performance profile is almost 10% away from the insane one and close to 6% away from the extreme one. Conclusion. The architecture remains the same for those wondering why use the 13th generation CPU and not a 14th one. The most crucial difference between the i9-14900K and the i9-13900K is the higher boost clock at 6 GHz versus 5.8 GHz in the i9-13900K. I buy whatever CPUs I use in my reviews. I don't have any sponsors, so my budget is limited. This article's main conclusions are the following. Your power profile or settings will heavily affect the CPU's performance. You should set the power profile that best suits your cooling solution. The better the cooling solution you have, the higher the performance. Intel high-end CPUs are power hungry. You will need a capable power supply for optimal performance. My view now on this topic. I didn't notice any issues at all in my i9-13900K, which I pushed to the limits in my CPU cooler testing station for more than a year now. If you noticed any weird issues, given that these CPUs are incredibly power hungry, you should also check your power supply first to see if it is up to the task, because the problems in power delivery can create other problems. Given my experience as an electronics engineer for almost 3 decades now, I advise you this. Whenever you have a stability problem with your system or any device in general that needs power to operate, the first thing you should first check is the power delivery system. That is all, guys. Bye-bye.